guys, how's it going? Brennan here. Today we'll be learning how to play Green Light by Lord. This song consists mainly of open chords and has a relatively simple strumming pattern, which makes it a great choice for beginners. If you want to play along with the album, make sure your guitar is in standard tuning with a capo on the second fret. All right, let's have a look at the opening verse. All right, the verse is really straightforward. We're only going to be using three chords, an E minor, a G, and a C. If you listen really closely to the recording, you'll notice that the pianist is actually playing each chord only once, which means that when we play it on the guitar, we'll be strumming each chord downwards only once. Let's give that a try. E minor. I do my makeup in G, somebody else's car, C. E minor. We order different drinks at the same bars. And then we just repeat E minor, G, and C twice more for the final two lines of the verse. The next part of the song is the refrain. Just like in the verse, we're going to be using three chords with the same downward strumming pattern, but this time we'll be playing D, C, and E minor. All right, let's try that out with some lyrics. Those great whites, they have big teeth. Hope they bite you. Thought you said that you'd always be in love, but you're not in love no more. Did it frighten you? How we kiss when we dance on the light up floor, on the light up floor. And that's it. That's the entire refrain. Okay, next up we have the pre-chorus. The good news is that the pre-chorus, the chorus, and the outro use all the same chords and strumming patterns, which means that once we've learned this section, we'll basically know how to play the entire song. Now, there are a lot of different ways that you can approach this section. The method that I'll be showing you today is one of the easier ways to play it. We're only going to be using three chords, an F, a C, and a G. The F and the C chord are strummed with the following pattern. Down, down, up, up, down, up. Let's try that one more time, but with the C chord. Down, down, up, up, down, up. Next we have the G chord, which we'll be strumming like this. Down, down, up, up, down, up, up, down, up, up, down, up. Now this may seem pretty daunting at first, but if we divide the strumming pattern in half, you'll notice that the first half is identical to how we strum the F and the C chords. Down, down, up, up, down, up. So really, the only new thing is the second half of the pattern, which is up, down, up, up, down, up. This might take a little while to get used to, so don't worry if you can't get it right away. If you want to sing along with the recording, start singing on the third strum of the F chord.
But I hear sound. Sounds in my mind.
If you want to add a little bit more substance to your G chord, you can try lifting up your index finger every third strum like this. Now let's put that all together.
But I hear sound. Sounds in my mind.
Once you've gotten used to that strumming pattern, you can actually go back to the refrain section and use it there too. This is how the refrain would sound like if you use that pattern that we just learned.
Those great whites, they have big teeth. Hope they bite you. Thought you said you'd always be in love, but you're not in love. How we kiss, we dance on the light up floor, on the light up floor.
And I think that's about it. Hope you guys enjoyed this lesson. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. Make sure to keep on practicing, and I'll see you guys next time.